G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This is the photo that we are going to do this week. It's the photo that I call the arrival. We're going to start off this week with creating or setting up our character here. So as usual, let's get started. So with our character that we are going to use, this one's from the Big Bad Figure Pack from Neostock. I'll link that below because it is free at the moment. So if you want to have a look at that, the link will be below. But I just wanted my character to look a little bit different. So what I've done is added a pixel layer, change the blend mode to overlay, and then just grab my brush with opacity and flow at 100%. And if I zoom in, you'll see all these pieces that sort of look like metal pieces on her uniform here. And what I've done is just zoomed all the way in and with my brush colored just all these individual pieces in. So if I just zoom out and then turn that on, you can see what I've done. So I've just picked those pieces and colored them a different color to make it look a little bit better. Now with her visor here, because this is like a CGI character, I wanted to hide that fact a little bit. So I came over to this picture here and I really liked the visor. So what I've done using my selection brush, I've just cut the visor out. So I'm going to copy that over, Command C, and just bring it over to the picture here on our character. And I've just pasted it right on top here. I'm going to grab the move tool here and just move it into place and make it a bit bigger. And just sort of slide that around just until you sort of get a good sort of fit. And then what I'm going to do is zoom in a little bit. Just move that into place. And I'm going to come over here to the mesh warp tool. And I'm just going to warp that into place a little bit more just to get a better fit there. Maybe put that up there. And then just use these little handles just to move that around. About there, look pretty good. A little bit more down on the ear there, a little bit up. So that's not too bad at the moment. So let's hit apply on that. Now I want to create sort of a little area around her nose here. So I'm going to come back to the mesh warp tool again. I'm going to come down here to the line just above her nose here and double click. And you see how it's put that line there? And then right under the nose, I'm going to double click again. And then on this one, double click. Double click. So I've created that grid. What I'm going to do now is just this bottom one here, just move that up and you can see that moving up and maybe a little bit there as well. And then just move that up a bit more. Okay, let's hit apply on that. And you can see now that we've just got that little bend in the helmet there. So that looks a little bit better. So what we'll do now is add a mask to that. Grab our brush, and we want to go really low on the flow on this one, about 5%, all the way down to 5. Let's zoom in again, bring that down, fairly big brush, we want a great big brush, it's sort of quite big, about this size. Let's just brush over just until we can see her eyes there, and that looks pretty good. What we'll do now is bring the flow up to about 10%, and then slowly on this picture, let's bring her hair back into the picture here. Just blending it in quite slowly. Down the side here as well. And a tiny little bit just over that earpiece. We don't want to see that ear come through. So we're just nice and slowly. So that visor looks not too bad, so that's looking okay. So now I'm going to color the visor as well. So down here on our adjustments and down to recolor, clip it to the visor, and then we'll bring up the hue, bring that into the same sort of color as our suit there, so that looks pretty good. And another thing that we're going to do is just above the background, we'll add another pixel layer. We're still painting in black. We've got our brush. We've got a really low flow. We'll make our brush a lot smaller. And now we'll just add our shadow under the mask. And we can always bring that opacity down just a little bit. And a little bit more. Just till we sort of see where it's looking pretty good. I'm happy with that. I will just adjust the mask a little bit more with my mesh warp tool. I just want to bring that side in a little bit. maybe about there, and maybe the earpiece back a bit, about there, and hit apply. So there we go, command zero. So we've got our character all set now for our scene. Okay, now we've got our character all done. We can concentrate on the main picture, and we're going to start off with this picture of the alleyway here, and you can see the background down here. I am going to copy that with a command J, just turn off that bottom one for now. And I'm going to add a color adjustment to this with my adjustments, and I'm going to pick selective color and just clip that to the background. I'm going to make sure that the colors here are on neutrals, and I will start off with my little trick of 35 and minus 20, just gives that a little bit more atmosphere there. And we will add an exposure to this a little bit later, but we're just going to have it like that for now. So now we'll turn our character back on that I created earlier. So we'll just have all those assets back there. And the one thing I'm going to do before I do anything, just on my character here, where I did this color, all the colors, I got to do the hair. So it's still on overlay. I'll grab my little color picker here just so I can get this color here and activate it. This layer, the pixel layer, is already on overlay, so I'll grab my brush. Just make sure that color activated. I'll put a flow of about 25%, and I just wanted to go over the character's hair a little bit just to blend that in. I think it looks a little bit better than the brown hair. So there we go. That's one thing I forgot to do when I was doing the character. So that looks a little bit better. So what I'm going to do now is with this character, going to highlight the helmet, the colors, and the shadow layer underneath. I'm just going to come up to here, layer, and merge selected. And then with the character, still on the character layer, now it's all merged. I'm going to grab my selection brush tool, brush a little bit bigger, and I'm just going to select just the legs of my character here, and just a little bit up the top as well. So just about like that. And then on the character, I'm going to go Command X and then Command V. And that's going to separate the top and the bottom. So this one here is just the legs. And this one here is just the top body. And we'll turn both of those back on. So we've got both of those there, the legs and the top body. So on the top body here, I'm just going to add an exposure and clip it and just make that a little bit darker. And I'm also going to add another exposure, clip that as well and make that a lot brighter. That one I'm going to invert and get my colors back to default by hitting D on the keyboard. Just a fairly sort of soft brush. Grabbing my brush, flow probably about 60% on this. And I'm on that exposure. I want white, so I'm going to X on my keyboard for white. Make my brush a lot bigger. And I'm just going to add some of my highlights in just on the top body here. Down this side. Okay, that looks pretty good. So the next thing I will bring in now is these rocks. Let's turn on these rocks and grab our move tool. Sure, on those rocks, we can call those rocks, hit enter, make that a bit smaller. I want it behind the arm here, so it's going to have to go behind the top body, so it's behind. I'm going to grab the mesh warp tool and just warp them out a little bit so they're up, sort of fitting in a little bit of an indentation there. Hit apply, back onto the move tool, and just put those about there. I will add a recolor to them as well. Clip that and just bring that into that sort of bluey, sort of lighter bluey color about there. We can always tweak that later. I'm going to duplicate that, and one of them I'm just going to bring below the legs here. And that can go on this side, and I might flip that, arrange, flip horizontal. So it's sort of going out the other way. It's not too bad. Okay, that looks okay for now. What we'll do now is bring over the picture of this ring here. So we've got this one here, and I'm going to bring that right underneath, sort of right underneath everything, right down here above the background. For this, I'm going to change the blend mode to screen. Again, add a recolor. Clip it. We'll make it that bluey color as well. Now for this one, we're going to grab our perspective tool. And I want this one sort of like it's on the ground here. So I'm going to drag that all the way down, make my picture a bit smaller. So I'm going to pull these ones all the way out to these corners here, and this one down a little bit. About like that. So our character looks like they're in the circle. So I hit apply, command zero. And then on that ring, I'm going to add a layer effects down here and click on outer glow. Clicking on the color, I'll grab this little color picker and pick again, pick this blue, activate it, and we'll give it a bit of a glow. About there, looks pretty good. Okay, so that's looking okay. Let's go command minus so we can see the picture a little bit better. I'm going to add another one of these, command J. I'm going to lift it up into about the middle here. But on this one, I'm going to grab my erase brush. I'm just going to take some of that flare at the back there off. There we go. So I like that. So we've got our two rings in place. So what we'll do now, see our legs are up here. We're going to bring those back down. So we've got the top and the bottom. And now the ring that we just created, this one here, we're going to move into the middle. So now you can see that our character looks like they're in the middle of this ring. And on this one, I might grab my erase brush tool again and just get rid of some of that in there as well. That looks a little bit better. So the next picture we're going to turn on is going to be this one here. I'm going to turn that one on, and I'm going to move that one in between the body and the legs as well. So it looks like she's coming through, our character's coming through that as well. And we're going to recolor that sort of like a swirl, and we'll recolor that swirl as well. Nice and bright about there. And I'm going to duplicate that and come to arrange and flip the other one horizontal. So it gives us a bit more of that effect, and that looks pretty good. On the legs here, I'm going to turn the opacity down just a little bit. Maybe let's do it to 90, I think, at this stage. I want to sort of give the effect that that hasn't fully come through that portal yet. So to add a little bit more atmosphere, I'm going to grab this picture of this background here, and I'm going to bring it all the way down just at the back of the screen in front of the background. And we're going to change that blend mode to screen as well. We can turn that opacity down a little bit if we like. There we go. Just a tiny bit, maybe to 75, 77. I think that just gives that picture a little bit more atmosphere. And on the background, like I said, we're going to add an exposure. So let's add an exposure to that background and clip that and bring that exposure down a little bit. And on this top ring here, I'm going to bring the exposure down on that one a little bit as well. And that's down at about 70, that top one there. And I think that's starting to look pretty good. So let's just maybe drop the exposure on the top body as well. Let's add some embers to this picture. So I've got this picture of these embers right on top here. These are actually from the Benny Productions optics pack. So I can link that below if you like as well. But that is a cost for these assets from the Benny Productions optics pack. Well, we'll turn that one on. We'll turn the blend mode to screen as well. And we'll also add a recolor to that just to make it blend in a little bit more. And turn that down. We might make those just a little bit brighter. if we find that there's some in the way that don't look too good, we'll just click on that, grab our erase tool. We might just erase some of those around her hair and her face. The others look pretty good. Let's do one more little thing here. Let's just come down here, add a new pixel layer, come up to our brushes. We'll pick these IM Rensi brushes, the lens flare brush here, and we'll pick this one. Come to our colors, make sure we're in white. On our brush, again, make sure we're in white. Make that brush a little bit smaller. I'm just using my right and left bracket keys. Turn that a little bit, just using my arrow keys, and we'll just put a little bit of light there and maybe one on the toe down here. Not a big change, but sort of just adds a little bit to that picture. Now we can just come over to our layers, merge visible, up to our develop persona here. Let's bring the clarity up, give it a bit of pop, a tad down with the exposure, and bring up the vibrance. And I'm going to hit develop. So there you go, everybody. That is my tutorial for this week on the picture that I call the arrival. I do hope you have enjoyed the tutorial. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. Hit that notification bell so you know when I upload my next video. If you would like to support my channel, you can do it on the Super Thanks link, or you can head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site that will be linked below. Lots of free assets for you to use for your own composites. But until next time, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.